I'm Dion Diamond. In 1960, sit-ins broke out all over the South. And I was a student at Howard University. Anyway, we decided that we would go over to Arlington, Virginia, to a Cherrydale drugstore. And I guess that was our first sit-in. We were surrounded by George Lincoln Rockwell and the American Nazi Party. And we were spat upon, we were hit. Each time that I repeat some of the experiences of that, we're talking about 50 some years ago. And it still, brings out some very fervent memories. And I keep suggesting that I don't know how we could have accomplished, at least at Glen Echo, what we did. For those 2 years that we were involved, what we started was continued even after yours truly was no longer involved.
My name is Phil Taijutsu Nash. I teach Asian American history at the University of Maryland in College Park. I'm also a longtime board member and former staff attorney at the Asian American Legal Defense Fund in New York City. And I've been living about a mile from the Glen Echo Park and the Carousel since 1998. I mean, it's been over 20 years. So I know a little bit about the racial history of this country because in teaching Asian American history, it intersects with the history of African Americans, Latinx people, all the people who've grown up here. And it's a history that's not always a happy history. I like to think that we've come together for many good things, but there's been a history of bad things as well. And as I went to the park, I couldn't help but notice this history, and the Park Service has been good about putting some of it out there. And as I read about it, I realized that these wonderful rides, these wonderful swimming pools, other amenities were not available to the local African-American community. So I made sure to tell my kids about this and tell anybody else who wanted to know. I was fortunate as a young person that my parents brought me to the local YMCA in a big city in northern New Jersey, so I got to meet the Latinx and African American community and socialize the way that human beings do. But this is not true of Glen Echo Pool or Glen Echo Park for many years. So when I heard that there was going to be a celebration of the park, I decided to go there, and they were going to have a reopening of the carousel. It just sounded like a great event. I had been working with Senator Gwen Britt on the Equality Maryland issues, trying to have marriage equality for the LGBT community. So I knew who she was. I knew she was going to be speaking there. So my wife and I went on, I guess it was a Saturday or Sunday, whenever it was, and we were sitting in the audience, and she gave her usual eloquent speech. She was very articulate, very powerful. She was a diminutive woman, but boy, she was a powerhouse. And afterwards, she was invited to go to the carousel and to ride. And the history of this is that she and her fellow classmates from Georgetown had been prevented from riding. And in fact, they had deliberately tried to ride, just like with the lunch counter sit-ins around that same time period. They wanted to desegregate the park and desegregate the carousel. And she had been forcibly taken off and had been arrested. And the local Bannockburn community and many other people had rallied around her and around the other protesters. And again, when we talk about Black Lives Matter, why do we need Black Lives Matter? Excuse me, Black Lives didn't matter at that time. And frankly, they still don't to some people and in some circumstances. So Senator Britt, she was not a senator at the time. She was still a very brave and outspoken student. She went on to have a very distinguished career in the Maryland State Assembly and then as a state senator. And like I said, she had been a civil rights advocate for everyone, not just the Black community. And I know as an Asian American professor and somebody who also works in the Amazon with my wife supporting indigenous people, I mean, when you become a civil rights person, you can't be a civil rights person just for yourself. You must support human rights for everyone, because my safety, my rights extend from the tip of my nose out into the world, and they stop at the tip of your nose. And I think that's something that's not fundamentally understood in the society even today. So my wife said to me, it looks like Senator Britt is hesitating a little bit. And unspoken between us, we realized that Senator Britt, as strong as she was like any person who had had that type of trauma, feelings, aftershocks from having been taken off of that carousel and taken to jail. And as any civil rights person knows, when you're taken to jail, you don't know what's going to happen. You can't say what's going to happen. Back to the event, my wife said, why don't you just go up there and offer to stand with her? And so I said, sure. I walked up there and I said, hi. I said, hi, Gwen, because we knew who we were. And I said, mind if I just come up there with you? And she said, sure. So we didn't make any big thing about it. If there are any videos that have been taken about it, you don't notice anything in particular. But she went in and got on the horse. I didn't even help her there, and I didn't sit down. I realized I hadn't been invited as one of the dignitaries, so I just stood there at the front of her horse, and we just stood there. I just watched, and the music went, and the carousel is wonderful, as everyone knows, and I've ridden on it many times myself. But as I looked at her face during this, I noticed there was such a kaleidoscope of emotion. And I'm getting teared up now just looking at it, because when you think of all that she had been through, starting on that day, maybe starting before that, but as a young woman just trying to assert her rights, just trying to live a fun experience like everyone should have on that wonderful carousel, she instead had been dragged off and taken to jail and had a difficult civil rights struggle. So anyway, um papa, the music's going, everyone's enjoying themselves. And afterwards, being the seasoned professional she is, Senator Britt got off the horse, walked out, smiled, shook hands, went on to her next engagement. We never even talked about it.
Hi, I'm Bill Silverman, and I grew up in the Washington area. I went to Montgomery Blair High School, and I was at the high school at a time when this park was segregated. People can't believe that here in Maryland, in our lifetime, there was a segregation of this park. So a group of us from high school, we came here to picket, and we picketed along the main road there, and it wasn't pleasant. It was not pleasant, because people would drive by, and we had picket signs, and they would yell at us, and sometimes people would throw things out the window at us. But you know, we were high school students, we weren't going to be intimidated. And I grew up in a family that believed in social justice and believed in fighting for the rights of people who are not fairly treated. That was part of my background, my family background, and certainly my Jewish background. And it was just what you did because you felt it was the right thing to do. It wasn't super, dangerous, but it was scary a little bit when people yell things at you and throw things at you. I didn't get hurt or anything, but I'm glad I did. And so now when I come back to the park with my granddaughter, I have all those memories of after it was policy was changed, where we could come here with other high school kids.